Yeah. Hi, Sonia.
Oh, yeah, Sonia Lodge.
Hello, hello. Can you hear us out there and see us out there? Allison, Korn, can you see and hear us? Awesome. Dyer, yep. Eric is out there, and Sophia, wonderful. Let's give it just another minute. Looks like some people are back. Awesome. Okay, let's try it one more time. One quick wave or thumbs up if you can see and hear us. Hello, awesome, awesome. Well, the first thing you need to know is that this session is being recorded because we are eventually going to put it on our YouTube page for other families who can't make these sessions to view, okay? So just a heads up, if you're, it's recorded, full disclosure there. So thank you. Let's just get right to it. I'll do a screen share in just a minute, but just a quick introduction from the four of us. My name is Sun Say Turn. I'm the principal, spelled S-U-N, and I'll pass it to Mr. Watson.
Hi, everyone. I'm Brian Watson. I'm the assistant principal here at Monroe, and I'll pass it to Stephanie.
Hi, everyone. I'm Stephanie Perez, and I am the secretary here at Monroe.
Hey, everyone. I'm Anna Wellman, and I'm the registrar here at Monroe.
Awesome. And I see Allison and your daughter's name. I can't tell. Yep. And I've got, no worries. Yeah. Sonia and, yep, not sure how to pronounce the name, and Sophia and Eric and A. Dyer, right? Welcome. All right.
Jarl and Janine. So I'm the vice president of our lodge.
So oh, got it. Got it. Okay, got it. Got it. Okay, well, welcome. A couple of ways you can follow along. We put in the chat. If you want to click on that link in the chat, you can follow along on the slides. But and also, I'll do a screen share in just like 2 seconds, okay? And we apologize. We haven't done the Zoom thing like this since last year, and we're hoping not to do it again next week, but who knows? So let me do a screen share real fast. And give me a thumbs up if you can see that screen share. Awesome. Okay, here we go. Let's do it. The first thing you need to know, two things to preface all this is that one, Stephanie, Anna, Brian, and myself, we're just normal people, okay? Just want to be upfront. Brian and I, our goal this week is to wear flannel every day, and it's going to happen. So I want you to just know that we're just normal people. We have family, we have kids, just we're all the above. And so we're just normal people. So just take a deep breath. It's all good. That's the first thing. And the second thing is thank you for being here with us specific to Monroe Middle School. And our goal is to not persuade you or convince you that Monroe is like the best middle school out. That's not our goal. Our goal is to share information with you and talk about some cool things that we do and some good things happening, and that we give you enough information that you just make the best choice for you and your families, okay? Whether it's us or Cal Young or Kelly or Madison, it doesn't matter. We want what's best for your family, so we just want to make that very, very clear. Does that make sense? Does that feel okay? Awesome. Was that a thumbs up for the flannels or the school choice or both? Okay, so both. Awesome. So let's do it. I'm going to pass to Ms. Watson just to kind of get us going. Sorry, let me back up. The agenda, hello, hello. 15 to 20 minutes, a quick overview of some of our programs, and then really you can ask us questions, not just at the end, but if you have a burning question at any point during this conversation, just either raise your virtual hand or give us your real hand. It doesn't really matter. And we can stop and answer those questions because we really want to value your time and know that your answers, your questions are answered here to the best of our ability. And we do feel between the four of us that we can pretty much answer almost everything. So around specific to Monroe, okay? I'm going to pass this to Mr. Watson just to give you a little teaser about maybe some cool things we do on campus and how you can be involved as potential future parents. Here we go.
All right. Hey, thank you, Sun. As flannel wearing folk, this is our best attempt to convince you how great we are. But in all seriousness, these pictures, I think, are here to represent kind of our climate, our culture. We take a lot of pride in trying to have our school have a positive climate culture for all of our students. The top I think to your top left, the picture with the kids doing the Oregon O is a picture that we probably took on a Friday. We call them Friday around here, where students can wear their favorite college gear or their favorite, their Mustang merch is what we call it. So when you get used to our lingo, you'll hear us say merch for merchandise. We like to give out lots of free merch around here for the kids to get them hooked up and show some school spirit or college spirit. As you can see on the picture on the right, we have a student pointing at his back. This is our motto this year. We made a bunch of t-shirts that we've been giving out to students for good work on campus. This kid is showing off his all in, all Mustangs merch, which is awesome. He's rocking it. Bottom left, you might be like, what is that? What is that, a weird game? What is that game? That's cornhole. We set that up in our courtyard. And that is done during 2 days a week. We have something called Flex. And during that time, students who aren't called into classes to get support or one-on-one help with teachers have opportunities to be involved in either enrichment activities or just fun games. And it's been very popular this year. We've been piloting it. And so far, we feel like it's been pretty positive. We also like to do Spirit Weeks around here. Bottom right is some of our students enjoying Spirit Week. And Stephanie has done a good job of leading those this year for setting up different fun ones, different times of year. We also take a lot of pride in trying to support our community. And you can see that pictured with our Sheldon Region Food Pantry, which on the next slide has a really great picture of all the food we have and how much food is brought in by our amazing parent organization. The MPO has done an outstanding job of just getting support, and parents have come together to drop off food to support one another in this community. Just some of the happenings around Monroe, maybe hopefully it gives you some insight into our values, our mission, and how much we care about supporting our kids and our community. Picture on the far left is a program we have called Model Mustangs, where we recognize students weekly for being Model Mustangs. And that's an acronym for students that are super motivated, optimistic, embrace diversity, give effort, have leadership. We try to recognize that and give those students some kickbacks with either free merch or free pizza or free whatever, so that they have something to look forward to each week and they're recognized. And it's just all part of who we are. And so with that, I will pass it to, I believe, Sun again.
Yeah, Mr. Watson, what does merch stand for again?
We think it stands for merchandise around here.
Got it. Just fact checking. Yeah, and throughout, you'll hear a lot more about what a typical day looks like at Monroe and our demographics. And again, if you have any questions, just please raise your hand, unmute. Very casual, very informal. But for now, I'm going to pass it to our amazing registrar, Miss Anna Wellman, and she'll talk about Monroe and who we are.
Yeah, so we at Monroe, we're Monroe Middle School, and we have grades 6th, 7th, and 8th. Our feeder elementaries are Bertha Holt and Willa Gillespie. And then we also have the Spanish immersion program with us. So Buena Vista feeds into us as well. And then our students go from us and they feed into Sheldon High School. We hover right around somewhere between about 550 to 600 kiddos. Right now we're about like 565. And so pretty big school, one of the bigger ones, but yeah, that's a little bit of info about us.
And then now Mr. Watson is gonna talk about what a typical, you might be wondering, what does a typical day look like at Monroe? And if you aren't wondering it, we're gonna tell you anyways. And then also Anna's then gonna piggyback off that and tell you more about what a typical year looks like in terms of like, how many electives do I get? Is it a year long? Is it a try? Like, I mean, some of those logistics. So go tag team and we'll be back again here in a sec, okay? Cool.
Thanks, son. A typical day at Monroe, I see our student looking closely at that schedule. Yeah, it's really exciting. Whenever I go to the elementary schools and tell them what a typical day at Monroe looks like, they're all excited. They're like, wait, what? School starts at 9 o'clock? Mm-hmm. Are you kidding me? That is awesome. I get to sleep in. I get to have like a later day. That's so great for me. So yeah, we start a little bit later at the middle schools than we do at the elementary schools. Our class periods are roughly 50 minutes with 5-minute passing times. Every student is given a teacher each year for advisory. And during advisory, they learn about social emotional skills that they might need to be successful in middle school and life. They play fun games, they get to know each other, they just do different activities that you wouldn't typically do in a normal class so that they can explore, think, whether it's school policies or how to navigate friendships or what to do when something happens that you're peer pressure, you know, those kinds of things. It's a great place to have those conversations. When they're not in advisory, they're doing the cornhole activity that I showed you. They're out on the blacktop or in the courtyard, either part of a really fun enrichment activity. It might be in a classroom with the teacher getting one-on-one support or 10-on-1 support, you know, depending on the day, and whether it's math or science, or they might be in art doing some creative project or just doing something that's really enriching for them. We have 3 lunches. One for each grade level. So our 6th graders have the first lunch, and those lunches are 30 minutes. And then our 7th graders have our second lunch, and our 8th graders have our third lunch. So there's no, with being the size of school that we are, we typically have about 150 plus kids in our cafeteria, which is about all it can support. So it makes sense to have 3 lunches just to give kids space and allow them to really hang out with their peers. And then our day wraps up at 3:35, unless it's a Friday, which is an earlier release, and that day ends at 2:35. So that is a typical school day here at Monroe. And again, like Sun said, if you have questions or want to jump in, you can either raise your virtual hand or just unmute or just ask a question. We're real casual, so feel free to jump in at any time if something comes up. And so I'll just take a quick pause and see if there are any questions on the schedule.
I actually had a quick question, if you're okay with me interrupting you.
Absolutely.
I was curious if your advisory flex period, when I look at the schedule, you know, 6th, 7th, and 8th, I'll have it at the same time. Are they mixed groups in that, or is it all 6th grade, all 7th grade, all 8th, depending on their grade?
Great question. Yeah, no, we actually don't have it as mixed grade. There's been a lot of discussion. I know different schools do it different ways. Some mix, some don't. Our all 3 grade levels receive the same lesson, but our teachers have really liked that. Some teachers, I wouldn't say that we have 100% everyone's on the same page, but most teachers like that there are different conversations that can be had around different issues depending on your grade level and the level of complexity that is shared in those. And so some of those conversations can be really different at an eighth grade lens versus a 6th grade lens. And so although the content's the same, it can be catered to the different grade level. So great question. Thank you.
Hey, just to further clarify that, for the advisory, that's the case for the grade level, but once on those flex days where kids go to all these different spaces and rooms and get support from teachers, that is across the school. So you could have a 6th grader playing ping pong versus an 8th grader in the courtyard, or you could have a math teacher who happens to teach 8th grade, but also 6th grade, pull in some 6th graders and pull in some 8th graders to do maybe retake a quiz, right? So for the flex component, it is mixed potentially, but then for the advisor, like Mr. Watson said, it is great by grade level. So hopefully that makes sense.
Yeah, thanks, Sam, for sharing that as well. That's important. Yeah, we try to have kids get to know each other throughout our campus as much as possible, regardless of grade. With that, Anna, yeah,
you have us at ping pong.
Yeah. Hey, Anna, with that, would you like to talk about the typical year?
Yeah, absolutely. So all of our students have, as you can see, 6 periods plus advisory during the day. And all of our students take 4 core classes. So they take math, science, and then block, which is language arts and social studies. And block takes up 2 periods. And then as we currently have it set up is our students get to pick a year-long elective. And we'll talk about which classes we have a little bit later. But they get 1 year-long elective, and then on their other elective spot, their 6th class is a rotation. So we have right now we have art, PE, and health that rotate. For our Spanish immersion students, we have PE, health, and discover. And then we also have PE, health, and current events. So all of our students take PE and health, and they get their year-long elective. And then they also get 1 trimester of an additional elective, art, discover, or current events, depending on which one they select. That is, and as I'm thinking about it, that is for our seventh and eighth graders. For our sixth graders, we like to have them explore a lot of different things to kind of get a taste of what we offer for year longs. And so our sixth graders do get one choice of a year long, which is beginning band. And then outside of that, if they don't want that, they could have up to six different ones, two different rotations of three classes for each trimester. And we've got a lot of variety there that they get to choose, but every student gets two elective class periods. And I don't know if that, hopefully that made sense. Please ask questions if it was confusing.
Hey, Anna, I've got a quick question here. Eric, yeah. We're coming from Buena Vista. Mm-hmm. And when you talk about that block, I assume that's our Spanish block. Is that correct? And then math and the others are English with school-wide or grade-wide?
Correct. Yeah. So for sixth grade, the class that they have in Spanish is going to be their block class, correct? That language arts and social studies. And then for our seventh and eighth graders who are in Spanish immersion, it will be their block class and then that discover class as well. So our sixth graders just have that those two classes in Spanish.
Yeah, thank you.
Of course.
Great question. Any other questions about what a typical day or what a typical year might look like or feel like? I know this is a lot coming at you, but just wanted to also just open it up if you have any. If not, it's all good.
And it is, I know just coming from the elementary, we do three trimesters at the middle school instead of two semesters as they do at the elementary. So that's where we get those three rotations and there's three trimesters here.
Yep, three trimesters at 12 weeks each. So
yes,
versus one semester at 18 weeks, I think. So
that sounds right.
All right, our math sounds right. All right, can you pull up the calculator and check that out, Anna?
Yeah.
All right, let's keep going. I'm gonna talk about some school highlights and then we're just gonna just keep going. If you have questions, please ask. So here are some things that when we made this, we feel like we're proud of, some things that make us stand out, or just some things that we do at Monroe. So we do have a school-wide literacy program. We call it CER, Claim Evidence Reasoning, that we have posters around campus. We really try to teach kids to kind of use that common language about making a claim, providing some evidence, providing some reasoning. So not just skills for kids, but life skills and adult skills in terms of being able to think critically and provide essentially, some commentary and some evidence when you make claims. So some critical thinking there. We have a program, much like every other middle school, called AVID, Advancement Via Individual Determination, kind of school-wide best practice instructional strategies, really to encourage kids to pursue college and career readiness. That we have one class of that, about 20 to 25 kids each year. And a lot of them will kind of feed into the Sheldon pipeline and continue this AVID program. That's there as well. Mr. Watson talked about advisory and flex a little bit. So I won't dig in too much to that, but it's a delicate balance of like social emotional learning with school business, with built-in supports and enrichments during the school day. And that's currently 4 days a week, advisory twice and flex twice, exact same time period, which was like right after first period. So he talked about that. We have site council. Every middle school has a site council. We meet once a month. This year it's on Zoom, obviously. We have, I don't know how many parents, Stephanie, so far this year joining us consistently. I can't even.
I have about seven parents right now.
Great parents, super great things. They're all really motivated and just happy to be there. And recently, we asked, I think for them, they're like, we want to be involved. We want to feel like we're making a difference. And so one thing they did this year, we just got 500 water bottles or 600, something like that, donated from a parent of a friend who knows someone. Because there was a need at the school because we shut off our water fountains because of COVID. And so now they have to fill them up with the dispenser thing. So that was cool. That was all through site council. And so that's just an example of how parents can stay involved. I'm gonna pause there and see if you have any questions before I pass it to Mr. Watson. Anybody? If not, we're gonna go to the learning with my Nomi slide.
Nice. I just wanted to give another second there for questions. Feel free to interrupt me if you do have questions that come up from the previous slide or any of the slides. We have world languages at Monroe. We have both a strong French program. We offer, it's called Explore French for our sixth graders so that they can get a taste of it to see if they want to take French 1 as a seventh grader. We currently have kind of a combined French 1-2 class based on class size and numbers. So we do offer technically French 1 and French 2. It's just a combined course. And then we have a Spanish 1 class as well. We also offer Explore Spanish. So those two classes are for our students that aren't in the SI program. That just want to experience Spanish and get a taste of it before high school. And then we also have our Spanish immersion program, which is 6 through 8, and is generally about 2.5 periods of the student's day in Spanish, learning language arts, social studies, and Discover. So that's how our SI program looks. I already talked a little bit about our PBIS program with the Model Mustangs and our campus climate and culture and all the things we're doing with kids to reinforce their behavior and just make it a positive school campus. We like to have lots of positive signs and kindness messages and all sorts of things throughout the year just to reinforce what we're teaching in advisory and just motivate kids to make good choices and be the best version of themselves that they can be. And we do a lot of that work with the outside help of our MPO again, which I've talked about before, how awesome they are. Any parent can be a part of our MPO and join. And I believe our MPO even helped make these signs as well as the food drive. And so they're always thinking of fun, creative ways to just help make our campus better and more positive and more inspiring place. So I can't say enough about that group. Any questions on this particular slide or in general before we move forward?
Awesome. Thank you, Mr. Watson. And I think that sign was for the fall and the new one says chillin' with my homies because it's the winter, get it? So it says chillin', I think. So they're very creative. Let's see what the next one is. Let's take a look here. A couple other highlights, math, we have your basic math 6, math 7, math 8. Math 8, where most students are at grade level, but we also do have some extended learning opportunities specific to math, where some kids are essentially taking one grade ahead, whether it's math 7A, advanced 7, or we have some 8th graders in algebra, where they can actually get high school credit if they pass. And then we actually have a handful of kids that get bused over to Sheldon High School to take geometry. So we do have like grade level math, but also a few other opportunities to essentially test into a more advanced class. So, and that's the only one that we have where it's more about an advanced track, if that makes sense. iPads, love them or not, they're here, we love iPads. So every student gets their own iPad and that's every middle school. So I think elementary as well, I think everyone's a one-on-one. I think I'm seeing the heads nods and whether you love them or not, we love technology and it's here to stay. So we use iPads. At the middle school, they use Seesaw. Is that correct? The program, Seesaw? And middle and high school, we're using Canvas. That's our learning management system platform. So much like the University of Oregon and Oregon State, I think they're also using Canvas. So it is more robust in that sense in terms of functions and features. But we are a Canvas iPad district at this point. Web. Every middle school has this web program. It stands for Where Everyone Belongs. We understand how hard it is to transition from 5th to 6th grade, right? So we have amazing 8th graders that have been kind of hand selected from our staff to help usher the 6th graders in. And we do day one assemblies. And we have these amazing web t-shirts that Stephanie really loves. She wears them almost every Wednesday. They're really amazing. And it's so they really stand out so that kids see who these web leaders are and same with the staff. And so they find a positive staff member and a positive kid to help usher them and support them throughout the course of the year. And so that's a pretty common thing in middle schools is this web program. And we have two amazing web leaders. Two of our math teachers actually are web leaders and they're awesome at it. So, and we have all sorts of clubs here. Some are currently established, some are being established, some will be re-established. We have our GSA, our Gay Straight Alliance, our Native American Student Union, Black Student Union, our Latinx Student Union. We have a yearbook club. We've had a homework club in the past. We've had a chess club. We've had a debate club. We've had a foursquare club. Because of COVID, we can't club as much, okay? We can't go clubbing anymore because of COVID. Except for you at the lodge. And so with that said, we take pride in having lots of activities for all sorts of students from all walks of life. But again, because of COVID, we've had to kind of restrict some of those things or get creative with them. All right, I'm gonna pause there. Here's a random flyer about Spirit Week that we love to have. Usually it's a fall Spirit Week, right, Stephanie? And then we do a winter and a spring. So three times a year, kids love to dress up and it's pretty fun. That was fast, okay? Coffee's kicked in. What questions do you have before we move on to the next slide? A question from Allison Corrin or your daughter.
Is yearbook only for eighth graders or?
This year, do we have all grades helping, Stephanie or Anna, or is it just seventh and eighth?
All grades.
Yep. And we have a teacher who leads it and advises. And I think today is the first day they were taking pictures, right? So they're walking around with their cameras and taking pictures of all sorts of activities so they can eventually put them into our system to make the yearbook. Yeah, it's cool. Yep, good question. Any other questions? If not, I'll pass it to Mr. Watson.
Awesome, thanks, son. Just kind of continuing down the track of our school highlights here. One of the programs that we had in the past, we had actually one of the largest programs of mentor lunch in our community, but we haven't had it obviously because of COVID, but we would have adults that were checked off for being volunteers that were able to come into our school during the lunchtime and meet with kids and kind of be a one-on-one mentor for them and just support them and get to know them. And it's an awesome program. And in a non-COVID year, we're gonna hopefully be able to get that going again. Like I talked about a little bit already, we have a strong intramural program where we give out some merch for students that win. We have a basketball tournament 3-on-3 coming up for kids to form teams and take on staff and take on each other with brackets. We've done some fun ones. We've done Mario Kart, volleyball, dodgeball, badminton, just a whole bunch of different intramurals throughout the day. And I think we've spent quite a bit of time on our elective classes that we offer. And I know that in the spring, we'll go to the elementary schools and we will give a presentation at each school and talk about what our electives are. And we will give students either a piece of paper where they choose their electives and you sign off and it comes back to us, or we'll do it via Google. If we have to do this like via Zoom, we'll do it via Google and you'll have a Google form where you'll get to choose the electives, and there will be a big explanation about what each one is and who teaches it and what it looks like for the kids. And if you have questions, you'll reach out to either myself or Anna, and we will get your student the best schedule that we can give them the best elective choice that we can to make them happy and just make it a positive start. So that is most of our presentation, I believe. And now we're just going to open it up to you guys to do some talking and asking and maybe bringing up things that we didn't cover that you'd like to know or anything you'd like to know more about.
Any question? Nothing is off the table. Just want to we're just normal people that like to wear flannels every day. And so just please, any questions you might have or wonderings, or just please ask. And I see Sophia with the hand up. So go ahead and unmute Sophia.
I was wondering if there's student council.
Yeah, that's a great question, Sophia. We have had a student council program until kind of the disruption with COVID. Last year, we didn't have one. It was kind of hard to do something offsite. When we returned back to this school year, we struggled a little bit to kind of have clubs and activities, different things. And so we're sort of building things back slowly. We don't currently have a teacher leading student council, but it is something we've had before. And I do think by the time you get here, we will probably have a student council again.
Great question. There's another hand up there. Yep, go ahead, yeah.
Okay, I was wondering, at the middle school level, do you have title supports for reading and for math? Or how does that work at the middle
school? Sure, yeah, and Brian, maybe you can speak to the 180 and 44 a little bit.
We're not a title school, so we don't have title support, but we do have reading support classes. We have two that we offer. We have one called System 44 for students that are two or more grade levels behind in reading. And then we have Read 180 for students that are usually one to two grade levels behind. And those take the place of an elective, but students can advance through those. And once they graduate, so to speak, or once they're reading at grade level, they transition into an elective.
Yeah, and then specific to math, we do have one math support class. It's currently at the seventh grade level. I think last year was at the eighth grade. And so every year we're looking at what grade level might be kind of best suited for that. So really, if you're not in that class, the best way to get support is from their teacher directly, either in class, before school, after school, or during the school day, during that flex time. So a lot of our math teachers, almost all of them have what we call flex support the whole year. So they're pulling kids in. I walk through two math classes today, and they've got two pods of kids here and a group of kids here working on either some new learning, some previous learning, or retaking a quiz during the school day. Which is really wonderful for kids who can't stay after school or get to school early. So that's one way to provide support for kids, knowing that it's not the perfect solution, but it is a way to provide some support in-house for math specifically. Question from Allison Corrin.
Do you have a theater program? And if so, how many productions per year?
Yeah, anybody want to take a step? Brian or Anna or Stephanie, anybody want to speak to that?
Yeah, we do have a theater program. As Watson has touched on a couple times, is things are, we're sort of figuring it out after returning from being closed during the CDL. But we actually have auditions tomorrow for our play that we're going to start working on. So we do have one. Typically it's about one play per year, but there is, during that flex support time, one of those enrichments we have is actually theater. And so kids go in there and they're doing all sorts of fun stuff. Today they actually did a reading through their play. So, but we do have usually one play a year that they do. Mm-hmm.
Good question. Any other questions from the audience? There's no bad question.
Man, all right, I'm asking because my son asked, do you guys have a playground?
We have a couple. So we have how it works. I'll kind of drill down a little bit. Everyone gets a 30-minute lunch. Everyone sits down for 10 minutes and eats their lunch. At the 10-minute mark, Brian and I usually have to cheat and push it to like a 6-minute mark. We say, hey, either the gyms or our blacktop, which is our playground, is available. Depending, like for example, today the weather was amazing, so kids are on the blacktop. We have 4-square wall ball, basketball, football, soccer. There's no like play structure, but it is like a playground. And then we have the gym available, and the gym's usually available before school as well. And so that we do have like a built-in recess. And yes, hundreds of most kids are outside or in the gym during lunch recess, we call it, and then the same thing goes for our flex. We have all those things available and more during our flex time during the school day. So Mr. Brian and I joked the other day that some kids get here before school, they're playing basketball from 8:30 to 9. Then on a flex day, they're playing more basketball from 9:50 to 9:30 to 10. And then they eat lunch for 10 minutes and play basketball again. And so by the time fifth period rolls around, they're really tired. So yeah, we have a lot of ways for kids to be active and play with their friends, for sure.
Jarl, I would say that our top three playground or recess activities for middle school kids are basketball, 4-square, and hanging out, socializing.
Eric, do you have another question? Do you have a question, Eric?
Hi, this is Ryder. How do the lockers work?
I can answer that for you. They work by taking a spinning combo pad and going two to the right, one to the left, one to the right, and then pushing a button up, opens. So we'll teach you that. We'll have lots of eighth graders and teachers in the hallways kind of walking you through it. There will be signs everywhere. And by the end of your first day with just sixth graders on campus, you will know how to do it and you will be an expert. I promise you.
All right, sounds good.
And that made me think of last year or 2 years ago, I can't even remember, we made, because of online learning, we couldn't have families come into our school for a school tour. So we actually made a school tour video that we posted on our YouTube page that has like 6.2 million followers, Mr. Watson. I just put it in the chat. So you can either click on that later and look at it or just type in like Monroe Mustangs YouTube and you'll see it's this like school tour, I think, right? Something like that. And so you can watch that 5 minute video in your free time. So if you're curious about what the school looks like and feels like, click on the video. But if you really, really would like a tour because you can schedule something with Stephanie and we're happy to walk your student around. Unfortunately, we can't have parent visitors, but if your student wants a little tour, we can walk around. We can make that happen in absence of lots of people coming in. So YouTube page or just email Stephanie, we can make it work. All right. Sophia, do you have another question or a question?
Do you happen to have choir?
Yeah, I'll let Anna speak to that.
Yeah, we do have a choir. Our band teacher also teaches choir. They're doing awesome this year. There's been a lot of interest in it, but we do currently have a year-long choir. Yes. So, and they've done performances in the past, like singing the national anthem and things like that. I'm not sure, with COVID, how things will look moving forward, but they do performances and things like that as well.
I will follow up on that too and just say that currently our choir is only for our seventh and eighth graders as a year long. So it's not a sixth grade explorer rotation. That could change, but it hasn't traditionally been that. So you have to kind of wait until seventh grade and eighth grade to have it as a year long.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they just performed about a month and a half ago with our band. It's the same teacher. And so they did have a performance as part of that. And it was really, really wonderful. So. Let's go Allison and then Jeanine. I think you guys have your hand up again, right?
Yeah, I was wondering if she is marked tag, does she have to retake a test for middle school? And would I need to speak to individual teachers?
Sorry, you froze on the spot. Can you repeat that, or unless someone heard it? Sorry,
I heard it, son. I can take a stab at it. Our counselor Carrie Tilson, who's not here, is our tag coordinator, and she can work with you if you reach out to her. But there isn't another test to take when you get into middle school. But she will get your name and reach out to you and look at tag plans and create something. Or work with you to make sure that things go well for you, okay?
And go ahead, I think Jeanine, you guys have your hand up again.
All right, we're also curious, do you guys have like a home ec type class still where kids learn to eat, learn to make food and all the other fun things?
Or shop?
Or sew, or yeah.
Awesome. Good question. I wish we did, honestly. I think they used to have one here, I think, back in the day. We don't at this point, but we do have some teachers who are trying to lead some of these flex activities, for example. I think, don't we have a teacher who's trying to crochet some beanies right now? Is that true?
Yeah. Yep.
Nice. Crocheting, knitting, whatever. I don't know the difference, but some of that stuff we can try to do, and we have people interested in doing it, and we've had some summer programs this summer here hosted where they did some
macrame?
What did Mindy lead that group? I forget.
Makers Mark?
Makers Space or Makers Mark. So essentially they're doing all of these things you're talking about. But no, currently we don't have like a full-on home ec cooking or facts, food and consumer studies program at this point.
We did have a couple of Spanish immersion teachers, one who's no longer with us that was really into cooking and had his own cooking channel. And he had a couple enrichments where he taught kids different recipes and they did them from home because it was during distance learning. And then our other Spanish immersion teacher taught kids how to make homemade salsa and tortillas. And so there is an interest from our staff in doing that during the flex time to give kids opportunity. But we don't have like a kitchen or any places to cook, set up for that here at our school currently.
Good question. Another question, Allison, is that the same hand? We can't tell, sorry.
So she goes to Eugene Gokwin right now. Is your Japanese class a language class or just a cultural class?
I can speak to that one too. A great question. It's not meant to be like a Japanese one or like pure language instruction. It's meant to introduce students to the culture of Japan, and they do a little bit of writing. They do learn a little bit of entry-level language just to, as part of learning the culture, right? So they learn some basic stuff, but it's not designed to be like a Spanish one or a French one where all you kind of focus on is the language and build off of it. There's a lot of other activities around Japanese culture that are built into the class.
And that's currently for 7th and 8th graders, correct, Mr. Watson? Not 6th currently?
Correct, yes.
For sure. What other, these are really wonderful questions, by the way. I'm glad we're recording this. What other questions do you have?
No.
It's all good. Go ahead.
Sorry. For the site council, do you have student representatives on the site council as well?
We don't yet this year. We have had in the past. But we try to get student input, but at this point we don't, not, at least not this year. But we're open to it, and that's some schools do, I think. But yeah, that's not out of the realm of possibility by any means. Good question. Go ahead, keep it coming. It's all okay. Good.
Your MPO, is that basically the same as like a PTA, PTO type thing?
I'd say so, yeah. And Stephanie can maybe speak to a little more kind of how they function and some things they do for us. She works with them directly, but essentially, yes.
So our MPO, they do things like our school drive, our fall food drive, and then our winter holiday drive. They'll also do things for teachers or staff. They make a lot of our posters for the school. When we have like honor roll or student of the month, they'll put together little kits for the kids. So I think we did like you're a smart cookie for every honor roll, and everyone got this really cool cookie and some Smarties. So we hand that stuff out. They are a really good, they're a great group, and they help us out a lot. They're part of our community here. So, yeah.
Just don't eat the Smarties and the cookies at the same time. It's a really bad experiment.
Really quick, do you guys have school dances?
Go ahead, Watson.
We like to call them school socials around here. Because it's not just a dance. We have the cafeteria open for hanging out and food. We have different activities. We generally have like little tables set up around the courtyard with minute to win it type games. And I think there's bingo, and there's in the library, there's a movie and popcorn. And it's a whole bunch of different activities. And students that want to dance can go in and listen to some music. Usually there's a DJ. Not always though. And one of the things that the students don't love is that the lights are never as dark as they would like. But there is adult supervision in there walking around and making sure that, you know, students are respectful and dancing appropriately. And so, yeah, they're fun. We used to have those during a non-COVID year, one a trimester. For Monroe students only. So it wasn't a combination of like Cal Young and Monroe or whatever, but it's just Monroe students only. You had to have your student ID. We have not hosted one of those yet in this year, just based on the pandemic, but we're, it is something that we generally do, yeah.
Super fun. Any other questions? These are really wonderful questions. What other questions do you have, or wonderings, or concerns, or anything? We're an open book and happy to alleviate any concerns or questions or stressors you might have or be feeling, or anxieties around transition.
I'll just unmute. Is there still bus transportation provided for middle school?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
But I assume it depends on how far away you live from the school or not.
Yeah, they tend to deem about within a mile or less walking distance. So that doesn't mean you couldn't find a bus stop maybe that might be a little bit closer to walk, but about a mile or less they deem within walking distance. But yes, we still have bus routes at middle school.
Okay. Yep.
It's kind of wacky how the zoning works, right? Between from coming from Willa Gillespie, coming, going either to
Monroe.
Yeah.
We're like 3 minute walk to Cal Young, but we're zoned for Monroe.
Yeah, exactly. Other questions from anyone?
Can I tag onto that again? Is that a phone call to transportation to figure out where the best stop would be, or is that?
If you go, I'll put it in the chat. If you go to transportation's website, there's a link that says "Find my bus stop." And what you'll do is you'll put your address in there, and then it'll populate the schools that you're zoned for. And you would just click on Monroe, and then it'll show you the bus routes and the times and things like that. I'll put the link in the chat so that you can go ahead and click on the Find My Bus Stop link in there. But that'll tell you where the bus stop is.
Cool. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. Great questions. What else? Anything else from anyone?
Just a general comment. You guys, I love the energy. You guys have done a fantastic job. You had us at flannel shirts, ping pong, and basketball. We will definitely see you next year.
Yeah. Thanks, Eric. Appreciate it. Again, our goal is really not to like say that raw. It's just to be honest and open and answer questions and let you know that they're normal people here and they're great people at the schools. And wherever you go, it's all good. You're in good hands. But we're super proud of, I think, the things we've done here as a team. And Brian's been here for, 8 years, Brian Watson?
Yeah, I think this is good. I'm about my eighth year, something like that.
Eight, and Anna's fourth, I think. Stephanie's, two and a quarter? And I'm going on my third. So we've got a great team. And our other office, Nancy is attendance, and Molly is department secretary, and Buffy in the library. So we've got a carry our counselor as well, full-time counselor. We have a really great team and take lots of pride in just being caring and welcoming and supportive and open. Final call for questions. Can give you 10 seconds.
I teach at the elementary level, but wasn't born and raised in this country. Never done elementary school here, any school here other than teaching elementary. But now I forgot my question because you went with teacher. It's gone. If it's important, I'll email.
Cool. Sorry. Awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, and I was going to say, if you run into any questions, if you do need to do school choice to attend Monroe, you can email me and I can help kind of liaison with the school choice office and help support you if you have any issues with the application or any questions about it. So,
and all of our contact information is on the website. So if you go to the website under staff, you'll see all of our faces and our emails. And so we're really easy to find. So just anything, email us. And I think I saw another hand or someone else was yearning to share something. I'm not sure who, but go ahead.
Well, it came back. Just in general, I guess I was curious, are you housing like a CLC or a life skills program? Just kind of trying to get a feel for the rest of the programs that are there.
Yeah, I can speak to that one as well. We have a CLC and a learning center at Monroe. We used to have a life skills, but it moved to ATA and we haven't had that in a couple of years, but yes, we do have both of those programs at Monroe. We had, I think, one more as well. Is that you, Allison, again?
So, like I said, she's at Eugene Gokwan right now, but you guys are actually our neighborhood school. So is there anything we have to do in particular to make sure she doesn't automatically get fed into Kelly?
Yeah, what you'll want to do is you'll want to, and I can email it to you or send it to you. We'll want to get you an enrollment packet. We'll just enroll you at Monroe as like a new student for sixth grade. And then that way I can reach out to Eugene Gokwan to then what we call point her to our school.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Yes, of course.
You've won her over. So.
Any other questions? If not, once Stephanie, Anna, Brian, anything else to add?
I would just say that, like Eric said to us, I'd say you guys have been awesome, a great audience, and we're excited to get to know your student and our students, and thank you for coming on, 3:45 on a Wednesday middle of the week and making the time to join us, so thank you guys.
Yeah, thank you all. Reach out with questions and have a good night. Take care. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you later.
Take care. See you on the hill, Brian.
Yeah.